You are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Let's discover hard cover my brothers and sisters. This is enough so you can know what's up in the hood. Understood, understand his plan is put in gear to educate teenagers through his peers. The guests are teams, the hosts are teams, produced by teams. So let it be watched by teams. The situations that affect us are the topics we discuss on hard cover.
When we first came here, nos sentimos espantadas. Because we could not speak inglés porque acabamos de venir. When we first came here, nos sentimos espantadas. Because we could not speak inglés porque acabamos de venir. From Mexico, we felt awful. Porque cuando queríamos ir a la store, we didn't know how to tell lo que queríamos comprar. That's why the first months that we were here, we miss Mexico. Pero ya no, porque ahora ya sabemos un poquito de inglés. Now we can say lo que queríamos también. We didn't speak any English, we felt tristes porque cuando una persona estaba talking to us, we didn't know qué es lo que nos estaban diciendo.
So, you are probably wondering, where are we going on our adventure to Mexico? We are on our way to the Chihuahua capital of the province of Chihuahua in northern Mexico. And it's just a few hours away as we take off and trace the origin of what started off as a crop of survival and is now a staple product that is used in everyday products in some shape, form, or fashion. Since ancient times, Mexicans have been known as the corn people. Until this day, corn remains the most important component of their diet.
In Mexico, the corn is very important. It's one of the principal dishes is with meat. If you have a good meat, do you not is complete without tortillas?
The first day I made it to Mexico, my family had this big barbecue celebration and they invited like everybody over. And it was just so amazing to me. Like everyone just came together and ate and they barbecued everything. They barbecued the onions, the chili, stuffed with cheese, these huge steaks, everything. And everything tasted so good. That the next morning for breakfast, my mommy Ladona, which is the lady who I stay with, invited this Indian lady over to make gorditos. And gorditos are like pita bread in the US. And it came out so perfectly round. And we stuffed it with eggs and cheese. And then, oh my gosh, it was like, oh, so good. It was so good. I was like, wow.
This is good. Good. Y'all <It's not. laughs> gone. All in my tummy. Excellent thing.
So the next day, my main focus was lunch. And so Mommy Ladona took me to this traditional restaurant right off of this lake. And the restaurant was known for its blackened deep fried fish. And when I say it was so good, I mean, I don't even know how to understand. And of course, we ate tortillas with the fish and you can make the fish tacos or just eat the tortillas, just like, you know, like we eat garlic bread in the US. And while I was at the restaurant, I met two men from America. And they had some words that they wanted to share with us.
Corn was essential. You go back 30, 40 years ago. And of course now we go to the grocery store to pick up anything that we want to eat. Back in the day, and I can remember back, my mother telling me that my grandfather had 2 acres of land, and on those 2 acres of land, they would grow rice and corn for them to eat. So corn has a huge impact on all Mexican food. Corn tortillas, of course.
There is nothing like Mexican food. It is the ultimate. Recipes are handed down from generation to generation to generation. Where we are today, I'm in Chihuahua, down here on a business trip, and I'm here at this restaurant for the first time, and I've never had deep-fried fish before. I've had deep-fried turkey in the U.S., but not in Mexico. And this was a real experience.
The next day, I was kind of curious about the relationship between salsa dance and salsa food. So I took a salsa class and I asked the teacher as well, because we all know that salsa in Mexico is a traditional sauce that's made with different mixtures of vegetables like onions, mushrooms, avocado, lime, and tomatoes, and all put together. And then the salsa dance is a traditional Mexican dance. I asked the salsa teacher, what was the relationship?
No, it's related only in the Concepción, because the salsa, the food, is it's a mixture of everything, you know, different kind of chiles and spices, and the salsa, the dance, also the music, is also a combination of different sounds and different steps. So it's spicy, it's hot, it's exciting, it's hot.
Before I left, I had to taste a quesadilla. I needed a quesadilla. Oh my gosh. So I begged Mommy Ladona to make me quesadillas. She had the quesadillas with the cheese, refried beans, her special salsa. Oh my gosh. And mixed in between a corn tortilla. Oh, it tasted so good.
Wait a minute. And how do you look?
Hot. Oh my gosh, I just was like, I have never tasted a quesadilla as good as the one that I had on Mommy Ladona Farm in the U.S. While in Mexico, I learned a lot. I learned about myself. I got to do some relaxing, meet a lot of new people, a lot of welcoming people, a lot of loving people. I got to go on adventures. I got to taste Mexican food. But I also learned the importance of corn in Mexican culture. I mean, I would walk in the house and no food would be being cooked. But on the table, a plate of tortillas just set, ready to be eaten. So I think to know the importance of corn and how much it means to Mexican culture will help people in the U.S. become more appreciative of corn and how it's used in our everyday life, and maybe we wouldn't abuse it, but more so try to keep the tradition alive.
Everyone's dismissed.
Oh my God.
I'm late. Maria's gonna be mad at me. She told me to meet her at the Comales at 3:30.
Have a good weekend. Take care of yourself.
Later.
Bye. All right, stay.
Salt Marvel?
Salt Oscar?
What up, man?
And
Ms.
Gonzalez?
All right, let's go to
break. Eyes on the side today. I'm never gonna make it on time.
Never mind, I think he's dead.
What is this? Mom? Why are you crying? Oh my God, look at the altar. That's my basketball. What's going on here? Mom? Why are you... Oh my God, I don't believe it. I'm dead. My name is Juan Luis Ruben Martinez de Maria. I lived in Pilsen all my life. My whole life. Everything I wanted to do. So many places I wanted to go to. So many things I wanted to do. My Wilson, Harrison Park. Tony told me if I practice enough, I'd be sure to make the team. What would he think when he hears I'm dead? Too bad I'll never get to play for Tony.
Sure, I'm the park supervisor at Harrison Park. I've been at it about 7 months. Born and raised here in the Pilsen area for about 30 years. I oversee about 30 staff employees, ranging from lifeguards, therapeutic instructors, gymnastics instructors, dance instructors, rec leaders, and offering a variety of recreation activities for the community. Number one thing that pops out of my mind is meeting the family which bring in these children from the community and outside the community while they're little kids performing the activities that they've signed up. Just meeting the family, talking to them in the hallways, and just getting a feedback as far as what they like to happen, and just meeting them and talking to them. I think that's the best thing that I've seen. I would love to try to get more variety of children. We have been getting a group from the suburban people coming in. I would like to see more fresh and new activities and ideas for these people. Pretty much everything else is probably fine here.
I'll never play for Tony or get the chance to show off my game to Maria. I did a lot of things to try and impress my girl, like going to the Mexican Fine Arts Museum together. This was our favorite painting. Maria said it reminded her of us. My friend Lazaro, who works at the museum, told me it was a great place to visit.
Lo que más me gusta es la organización y el sentido de comunidad que hay. Me gusta cómo los ciudadanos de este barrio se han organizado y han traído su cultura, sus murales, su comida y se organizan para diferentes actividades. Siempre están unidos en comunidad.
On the 2nd of July, in the West Wing Gallery, we're opening our first exhibit on Pilsen. The exhibit will feature Pilsen, it will feature the history, the artist, objects, a lot of things on Pilsen. It'll be our first exhibit exclusively on Pilsen. Also next month, the museum will start its expansion. It will grow to the end of the block. It will be double in size. And also the museum will be opening a small school for young people. It will be a school that will educate young people, Mexican people, and other nationalities on art, on history.
And
so more than a museum, it's going to be a small school which will continue to educate and expand their education, which is a good thing.
Yes, my Maria loved art, and because I love her, I did too. I remember getting involved with painting murals to help beautify my neighborhood. The murals were beautiful and looked real. I especially liked the way the shapes, colors, and pictures told past and present stories about Mexican culture. I remember how my friend Silvino convinced me to take part in painting murals by sharing with me some of his experiences.
It was a good experience for me because since I know how to draw, I tried to do the best job I could. But what the mural signifies, it really doesn't signify anything. But I just had the opportunity to draw on this building, and it gave me the opportunity to develop my skills. It took me like 9 to 12 hours to complete. It wasn't difficult, but it did take some time because I tried to do the most perfect job that I possibly could.
Murals need no explanation. They represent themselves by their colors and pictures. More importantly, the murals tell stories about life, like the history of Pilsen itself. My grandfather gave me this beer bottle. I remember the stories he used to tell me about Pilsen and how it became a Mexican neighborhood. He told me how the name Pilsen came from a town in Czechoslovakia that made the beer and the bottle was proof. That's where the word Pilsner comes from, and I believe my grandfather's stories as well as those that a lot of the old-timers used to tell.
I was born and raised a few blocks down on 18th Place here, and my family still resides here on 21st and Kalana and all three area. I've still got nieces and nephews around here, and my sister. And
Finally, people are starting to notice the Pilsen neighborhood. And the young people, a lot of young people. I wish, it breaks my heart, believe me, I was born and raised in this neighborhood. We had a boys' club and things like that there, and it was great. Now these young fellows, they're wandering the streets. If somebody can get them together, because they got so much to lose in the future. With these gangs and things like that there, and I'm proud of this neighborhood. It's coming up now.
They're finally doing the sidewalks and the streets and things like that. They're progressing.
Hispanics started coming in there about 20 years ago, 25 years ago. And at one time it was all Polish and Irish and Anglos, you know. My parents, my father came from Mexico in 1919, and my mother came when she was about 3 years old. And they settled in Chicago. I mean, and at that time it was Mexicans you can count on one hand there. There was a very small group there. I remember when I was a little kid there at Gads Hill Center, and everybody was united then. Now. We're born, all six of us, my brothers, three brothers and three sisters, were born and raised in the neighborhood. over here. I was born at a house in an 18 place. At that time, you know, people didn't go to, well, they didn't have the money for hospitals. So, but it's improving there. And like I said, I see a lot of, like, all the stores that were dead before and they look terrible. Now they're coming up. People are investing in the neighborhood. It's like 26th Street. 26th Street was all them stores, and the Mexicans, Hispanics, they start coming in with all their businesses and whatnot. Now it looks nice. The streets need more more attention, and sidewalks, because they're all vaulted sidewalks in this neighborhood. I remember when I was a kid there, we had washrooms, well, the toilet under the sidewalk, and people are hard. What? I said, yes, and that's on 18th Place, and that's when we were kids there. And so, I mean, I've got some bad memories, and I got some good memories. I'm scared they're gonna push all the Hispanics out like they did on Roosevelt Road and Halsted. They moved them all out of there. They moved them in this neighborhood in the late 50s. Now I understand that they wanna put in new, some other people wanna shove somebody else out. And people gotta be proud, they gotta build up these houses. They gotta take care of their homes there.
Residents in the area do care about their homes. I know everyone in my house worked hard, long hours to make sure it was presentable. I went to school and then to my job at the factory. Many people in the neighborhood work hard and care about Pilsen. Some have their own businesses. Others toil in the streets selling their wares, like the paleta, or fruit vendors who spend long hours every day to make a few extra dollars. I remember how my barber, Raul, who's been in Pilsen for years, was really proud of how the neighborhood has changed.
I've been in this neighborhood for 21 years. In this neighborhood has changed in the sense that it's gotten better, there's less gangs, it's a little more calmer, and they've just finished tearing down this building in the corner here, where there used to be a lot of non-working people, a lot of lazy people there, and since they've torn that building down, it's gotten a lot better. It's a lot calmer, it's a lot more tranquil. It's gotten better in every aspect. More business, there's a lot more business. And everything's better now. Everything's better.
Too, I'm proud of my neighborhood and wanted to give something back to my community. I dreamed of becoming a firefighter like the brave guys I used to visit and talk to at the Engine Company 23.
Engine 23 is a good place to work. It's a fairly busy company. And it's a lot of good guys here. It's very interesting. Pilsen neighborhood has been it's been pretty quiet around here. Everybody's pretty good about taking care of their homes. They have their smoke detectors in place and operating. And the fires have been down considerably from years ago. Like I say, everybody's very good. You see every once in a while you see a little problem, but. But other than that, everybody seems very fine, very friendly. A lot of times, the school kids will walk down the block and they'll come in for a visit and we'll show them our apparatus and our equipment, and put on our turnout gear and show them how we operate the hoses and try to answer the questions for them. And the neighborhood is great. Like I say, it's nice, good people, good neighbors, take care of their homes and property pretty well. Around Easter, they reenact the Jesus Christ walking through the crucifixion of Jesus Christ, and a lot of times we'll go out there and help them hang banners or do what we can to help them out, whatever.
Religion, such as the Via Crucis, the reenactment of crucifixion of Christ, which the firefighters helped to set up signs for, has always been a big event in the community. Religion is important to our culture. It helps us to understand and put into perspective what our lives mean. I now come to understand that my life did have meaning. Many of the things I took for granted were extremely important. I know I must leave now and can no longer take part in the richness of what our town, our pueblo, has to offer in the way of our family, art, culture, and opportunities. You among the living have that chance. Don't waste your opportunities by not taking part in what Nuestro Pueblo de Pilsen has available for you. Goodbye.